Hey guys, just wanted to share with you some new gear I recently purchased. I was looking in the market for M14 magazine carriers, and believe it or not, they're kind of hard to find. In that I had three criterias that the mag carriers had to meet. I wanted Kydex. The advantages of Kydex is that it doesn't absorb moisture, such as nylon or the thousand denier materials. You know, if you're used to shooting in the rain or even snow, that absorbed moisture will add a little bit more weight, actually significantly more weight to your gear. So just by reducing that, Kydex is the better way to go. I wanted also an open top. I didn't want any kind of flaps, any kind of Velcro holding it together. And it had to fit on this war belt, okay, without taking too much space. So the design had to be efficient as far as not taking up as much real estate on the belt itself. Because this is not a chest rig, I don't have as much real estate to fit magazines or you know, pouches. So it had, the design itself had to be very efficient. So I came across a fellow YouTuber's channel, and it's called, his channel is called GunfightersINC, and got in contact with Adam and said, hey, you know, are you interested in making M14 mags? And he said, sure, you know, give me a couple days and he'll come up, or I'll come up with a design. And so I think within the next day or two, he emailed me and said, hey, I think I have something that might work. Let me put one together and test it out and you know, see how it works. And I'm very, very happy with these, because a lot of thought and engineering went into this design to make it as efficient as it is. And now, as you can see, I have it positioned so that these mags are on my left-hand side, my reloading side. And give you a better view of it here if I can. Okay. The way he designed these is that they interlock with each other. You can see there's two end pieces and the middle piece. And these are not connected in any way. Okay. They actually curve to the form of your body. Could see there, and they're extremely nice. Everything that he stated works perfectly. The magazine retention is perfect. Okay. Slides in, and maybe the last quarter part of the holster, you could feel that tension. Still, but though it's easy to pull these magazines out, same thing with this one. All three of them have great tension. Give you a closer look. Okay. There is no screws or anything to fall out. Everything's all permanently attached. And I'll show you how these are attached. They use malice clips, and they fit perfect on this belt platform with this molly webbing. Alright guys, I just wanted to show you up close the construction of this magazine carrier. Now it's a two-piece Kydex, okay? There's no screws, everything's all kind of riveted in. They're held together. Actually, this magazine carrier goes onto your system with these malice clips, and you basically weave these through your webbing, and they go into these little tabs here. And if you've never used these malice clips, they're extremely durable. Once you get it woven through your gear, your web gear, basically slides in and locks in place. Okay, and those are not going to go anywhere. I noticed that it was a very solid mount, and up close to your body, or up close to whatever gear you had. So that was an extremely nice thing to have. This back plate here that holds the malice clips These are all one, that's all one piece, and it's pretty much bonded to the Kydex shell itself. So extremely nice. Again, I really like the way that he raised this edge and lowered this section here so that you had something to index it with. Let me get a magazine real quick. You know, slides in perfectly, locks into place, and it's solid. Okay, but still, you easily can access that magazine quickly. So, a really, really nice Kydex magazine carrier, and I'm really happy with it. Adam, I wish you the best of luck with all this stuff, and I know you're going to do good because just the way things work, I think you're gonna have a pretty good business there. So that's just a close-up look at it. Very nice materials. I think this is a mil-spec Kydex material, as he mentioned, but very durable, and I think it's going to last for a lot of years of hard use. And I'll give you an update maybe in a few months on how these hold up, but I'm sure they're going to be just fine. So that's the close-up look at it. Okay. So he did an excellent job. Pretty much met every criteria that I had or I was looking for. And these are all, he hand makes this to your specifications. Okay, now if you notice here, even these little touches, okay, you'll notice that this is extended back here. Okay. Now that's a great thing because you can, without looking, index your magazine against here, you know, without fobbling around. If this were even, it'd be a little bit more difficult to insert the magazine. But with this extended plate, and also here's another extension here that you can actually just index your magazine up against the plate there and slide it in and push it in. Yeah, if you were to want to put your magazine in, you know, without looking at it. So that was a great a thought. So he actually, you know, probably took a lot of time and thinking to come up with this concept, but it works out great. It's a great product. I think he's going to be doing really good as far as making Kydex, you know, mag carriers. He makes holsters for hard to find. If you're having hard time finding a Kydex holster or Kydex magazine carrier for your particular weapon system, check him out. You know, get in contact with Adam, and I'll put a link up to directly to his channel, because I believe he's going to be doing a lot of work. Again, I paid for these. Now, he didn't give them to him for free, so this is not, you know, an endorsement of any type that you know, he gave me these free mag carriers. I bought these, and that's the way I prefer to do things, because if there's anything that's a negative, I'm going to tell you about it. Okay. Now, I was looking at these, and the actual N magazines on each side, okay, I was actually going to tell Adam, or give him some input and say, hey, you know, this flange should actually be closer to the belt itself. But after looking at it, if this flange was closer to the belt, I wouldn't be able to utilize this extra webbing that I have below here. Now I can actually slide another accessory or pouch and still be able to utilize this webbing section here. Okay, now if this flange here was actually lower and closer to the belt, I wouldn't be able to use that extra webbing gear. So, you know, I don't know if he thought about that or if it was just done by accident, but it actually works extremely well this way. Now I plan on ordering a dual magazine carrier for my Glock 17, which I run on this system on this belt here. So I plan on getting that and having him do me one, because this stuff is just nice. You know, it's not I wouldn't say it's not refined, but the best part of it is that it works and it's functional. I think it looks good. You know, I think it looks extremely well designed, and the most important part again, it's functional. Okay. Now you can nitpick here and there. You know, let me pull one of these magazines out here. Okay. You can nitpick. What he did was bevel or rounded off these edges, okay? And he did that with a Dremel tool. Now it doesn't look perfect. It, you know, it's doesn't look like it's something out of a factory that's, you know, stamped out, but it's functional. And I prefer functional over nitpicking over little stuff, you know. And that is a nice touch, and it's a great idea that he's kind of chamfered these edges so they're not so sharp and they're not so rough, and the magazine fits in there just smoothly. And that's the important thing. You know, you can have the prettiest gear, but if it doesn't work for you, if it's not functional, then it's pretty much useless, and you can put it in a frame and hang it on your wall. This stuff is functional. I think it looks great, and Adam did an excellent job on this. So if you're into maybe some AKs, I think he was planning on making some AK mag carriers. Those I know, I've never seen any kind of Kydex mag carriers for AK-47 magazines. So they're one-off stuff, and I'm sure he's going to be doing some other one-off items, and later, you know, maybe making them on a normal basis, on a regular basis. But if you're interested in these, contact Adam at I totally got lost now. At GunfightersINC. Okay, again, he's a fellow YouTuber. He's got several videos of his products up now, and I think he's got a video of these. So this is my I'm sharing my opinions on his mag carriers, and I think they're an excellent excellent item and an excellent piece of gear if you're looking for it. So thanks a lot, guys, for watching, and take care.